now. Okay, come back again in next video. Now we will define the force mathematically here, and also we have discussed Newton's second law, which is nothing but law of force. Discuss the definition like that. Force is nothing but force acting on an object is defined as the product of the mass with acceleration due to that. But it's not a more general definition of force. It's a special case of force. Definition of force. Now here we define general definition of the force, and then you can see that definition is you have discussed in last video is the special case of that. Now, the force acting on a body is defined as the rate of change of linear momentum with respect to time. F equals to delta P by delta P. Okay? Since linear momentum is a vector quantity, so force will be a vector quantity. Okay? Now, momentum of a particle or object is nothing but mass into velocity. So, force acting on this object will be equal to delta mv of delta v. If mass of the body आपका मास टाइम के साथ कांस्टेंट है, तो ये इससे क्या जाएगा, बाहर आ जाएगा, क्योंकि ये जो वैल्यू है आपकी, ये लीनियर मोमेंटम है, टू टाइम्स पर है टी टू माइनस टी वन, ठीक है ना। और यदि मास टाइम के साथ आपका चेंज होता है, तब ये इस चेंज वेरिएबल से बाहर, चेंज ऑपरेशन से बाहर नहीं निकलेगा। अब आप ये कहेंगे कि मास तो ऑलवेज कांस्टेंट होता है, बट आपको पता होगा या आप आगे चलकर जानेंगे कि जो किसी ऑब्जेक्ट का मास होता है वेलोसिटी डिपेंडेंट होता है। लार्ज वेलोसिटीज पर जो स्पीड ऑफ लाइट होती है उसकी यदि कंपेरेबल आपकी स्पीड हो तो उस कंडीशन में आपका मास इंक्रीज कर जाए। तो हम यहाँ कॉन्स्टेंट मास की बात करेंगे व्हेन द स्पीड ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज वेरी वेरी लेस देन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू स्पीड ऑफ लाइट, ठीक है ना। देन दैट मीन्स कब होगा ऐसा, v is very very smaller than the speed of light. Okay, F will be equal to mass becomes out of the operation delta vector v divided by delta v. It's nothing but the acceleration of the moving object. So we can write here. So you can see here, this formula is valid only for that or type of objects whose velocity is very very smaller than the speed of light. Otherwise, this formula is not valid. But this formula always valid. Okay. So this is the general case of the general definition of the electric force. Now, after that, we will define here. It is a vector force. Okay, whose direction? The direction of axis. And unit, its unit is kilogram meter per second square or newton SI and gram centimeter per second square or dye in CVS. Okay, dimensional formula. But for mass, kilogram for mass, what we take M is for length, L and second for time, M is for mass. ओके तो आप इन्हें कंप्लीट करिएगा. यदि कोई डाउट हो तो आप पूछ सकते हैं. तो नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में हम कुछ और डिस्कस करेंगे. आज के लिए इतना ही काफ़ी. ओके, थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.